Welcome to the world of precision and accuracy. Are you tired of spending hours creating models and animations in Blender? Do you want to learn how to create stunning 3D content in a fraction of the time? Then you've come to the right place. In this tutorial, we'll be diving into the world of snap with options in Blender. So buckle up, grab your mouse, and let's get snapping. In the previous video, we covered the basics of snapping, specifically the Snap To options found in the snapping menu. Make sure to view that video right away if you haven't already, so you can better understand this video. Upon closer inspection, you'll notice another section in the snapping menu called Snap With. So, what's the difference between these two, by the way? Snap To determines where the selected object will snap onto the target object. For example, if you select vertex snapping, the sphere will snap onto the vertices of the cube. On the other hand, Snap With determines which part of the selected object will snap with the target object. If you select center, you'll see that the sphere gets snapped by the center onto the cube. Out of the four Snap With options that Blender provides, we will start by looking at the closest. This option measures the distance between the selected and target objects and snaps the closest point of the selected object onto the target object. To better understand this, let's take a look at a special object with a sharp corner on one side. When in face project snapping mode, you can clearly see how the selected object snaps onto the target object. However, things get more interesting when we switch to vertex or edge snapping. In vertex snapping, you would expect the corner to snap onto one of the vertices of the cube. But in reality, this doesn't happen. So, what's going on? During the snapping process, Blender creates a bounding box for the geometry of the selected object. It calculates the closest point in the selected object and snaps that point onto the target object, but only by the corners of the bounding box, not by the closest point of the geometry itself. Following that, we'll look at the Center Snap With option. This option allows you to snap an object by its center. When I say center, I don't mean the real center of the geometry of the selected item, but rather the object's origin. If the object's origin is far away, it will still behave as if it is the center of the selected item. In edit mode, it draws a bounding box around the entire mesh and uses the center of that box as a snapping point to the target object. The median snap with option in Blender allows you to snap the median point of a selected object to the target object. The median point is the average location of all selected objects. This snap with option is useful when you want to align the center of a group of objects to another object. In edit mode, if you try to snap, it will take the median point of all the selected items. For example, if you subdivide this face right here, you can see the median point gets shifted towards that face. Keep in mind that the median point is affected by the position of the vertices. So if you modify the mesh, the median point will change as well. The active Snap With option in Blender allows you to snap one object to another based on the currently selected active object. This can be useful when you have multiple objects and want to snap them all to a specific point on one object. To use this option, first select the object you want to snap to, then select the objects you want to snap and make the desired one, the active object, by selecting it last. When you activate snapping, the active object will snap to the target object based on the Snap To option you have chosen. Note that the active object can be changed at any time by selecting a different object while in snapping mode. You can also select multiple snapping modes all at once by pressing Shift while selecting snapping modes. You can also select multiple target objects. When transforming a selection with snapping enabled, you have the option to mark highlighted snap targets by pressing the A key. With multiple such targets marked, the selection will then be snapped to their average location. That concludes our tutorial on Snap With options in Blender. By now, you should have a solid understanding of how to use the Snap With options to create precise and accurate models and animations. Share and subscribe the channel for more such Blender tutorials, and comment down below what tutorial you guys want next. In the meantime, try to watch our video about transform orientation and stay tuned. Until then, happy blending!